A show of confidence.
The point I want to make again is that our vaccine rollout is going well.
But behind the scenes, the jab numbers are jittery. Yesterday, there was tough talk.
The challenges Australia has been a supply problem. It's pure and simple. There was over 3 million doses from overseas that were contracted that never came.
Overnight, the European Union accepted it's held back a quarter of a million doses from Australia, but dismissed any suggestion it should take blame for further blockages.
We certainly cannot confirm any new decision to block vaccine exports to Australia or to any other country for that matter.
Any suggestion that I in any way made any criticism of the European Union yesterday would be completely incorrect.
Well, the bell is tolling for truth when it comes to Scott Morrison and the vaccine rollout. The promises just don't stack up. Australians just want to know one thing: when they are going to be vaccinated.
The Prime Minister is appealing to the EU again, asking for the extra supplies. He's already committed to divert 1 million of those doses to Papua New Guinea. Humanitarian groups are warning PNG case numbers could explode to more than a million within weeks. India has just committed to send 130,000 doses, but Scott Morrison won't say whether Australia could allow domestically manufactured vaccines to be sent to our closest neighbour.
We have been working with a number of other partners around the world to see how we can address that.
Locally made vaccines are starting to be released. So far, about 920,000 people across the country have at least had their first inoculation. Despite the continuing uncertainty, state governments are going ahead with large-scale vaccination centres.
The New South Wales government will also be setting up a vaccination hub at Homebush, and this is to allow us to support the Commonwealth in distributing the vaccine once we have finished the 300,000 that we said we would do.
Other nations facing ballooning COVID cases moved directly to mass vaccinations months ago.
It's not possible to stand up a large number of additional mass vaccination clinics. We don't have the vaccine to do that.
There are a lot of variables in this process. Supply chains get disrupted. Medical evidence comes forward, which requires us to address it.
Another reality check on public expectations. Tom Stainer, SBS World News.